it's a rapidly evolving situation. We're monitoring it closely. And the reality is we're not epidemiologists. And so as economists, we have to make some best guesses about different ways that the disease might run its course and ask, well, what would happen to the economy in different scenarios? We've seen a lot of movements in the asset markets. The Dow has been tumbling. You know, one thing to keep in mind is that the stock market is not the economy. So don't get me wrong, it's definitely not good news how far the Dow has been falling and what we've been seeing in the asset markets. But asset markets are more volatile than the underlying economy. Right now, in our baseline modeling, we don't see the epidemic causing an official recession. We do think that we're expecting a drop-off in economic activity, especially depending on the course of the epidemic, and we think that will be substantial. But we expect the effects to be short-lived enough that we don't meet the official definition for the economy to enter a recession. And in particular, we expect growth to start bouncing back in the third quarter of the year. And so that is in contrast to something like you might think about the financial crisis in 2008, where the effects really lasted for a very long time and we had a slow recovery out of the financial crisis. Here we expect a sharp but short-lived contraction in economic activity if the disease evolves as aggressively as some of the scenarios that we're seeing. But we do expect the economy to recover quickly enough that we'll avoid a recession.